Hey guys, it's me Tilly, and before I start the video, I want to apologize for there not being a cam again. I'm actually facing a few technical difficulties right now, and I'm re-recording this video for like the 10th time, and I hope this one will make it finally. So, today's topic is something that I promised you for a long time at this point. I never got around to do it because sometimes I thought it was not as important, and then at other times there were actually more important things like season 4 and everything. But finally, we will talk about Vindictus' stats and what you need to know about them. I will actually include timestamps for every single one of them, or like categories of them. So if you are looking for something very specific, definitely check the description to see all of the timestamps. With that being said, I'm gonna start with top left and I'll finish bottom right, just as a disclaimer. And the first four ones are what I describe minor stats: strength, intelligence, agility, and willpower. Strength and intelligence are not needed for every class. You only need one of them per character. And the way it works is intelligence is for magic attack, strength is for physical attack, right? That makes sense. You can check which class you are on the top right stat. For me it is M attack as in magic, so for me intelligence is interesting and I can ignore strength. Each point of intelligence gives you 2 magic attack, each point of strength gives you 2.8. This might sound unbalanced, but trust me, all of the items in the game yield more intelligence than they do strength, so overall it is somewhat balanced. Both of them also give you critical damage the more you have, but that's basically not really true because it is capped with 35% at 2000 points. And as you can see, I'm at 4.2k. Yes, I'm kind of min-max already, but even as a new player, I think if you hit level 90 and get the free gear, I think you should actually be there already. About agility and willpower, I'll only touch them real fast. They will give you stuff like more defense, more HP, higher stamina recovery, a lower knockdown rate, all of these things. But realistically, they're also soft capped and they don't scale linear. They are scaling in breakpoints, so every 105th point, something like this. I think you should not be paying attention to them because there's not really a way to gear towards them, right? Whereas if you need balance, you can go for specific scrolls, you can do your Einlacker, yada yada. But for these two, they come with every piece that you get, with all of the accessories, with your armor, with your weapon. There's only really ever should you synthesize them as soon as possible, to which the answer is no. Synthesizing your balance, crit, and attack speed first will always be the right call. I wanted to cover them anyways, just so you know. Alright, let's move on with the fifth stat overall. And it's actually one that gives even a few veteran players a hard time, and it is luck. There are two parts to it. The first part is, once you have one additional luck, and the basic is 100, so I am at 110, that means I have 10 additional luck, right? But if you only have one additional luck, you are guaranteed to get one additional core from every battle, which is already pretty huge. And then there's the second part, where per point of luck, you get a 1.5% chance to roll additional luck cores based on the basic the amount of basic drops that you get, right? So let me just explain this real fast. Whenever you kill a boss and all of the loot shows up in chat, you might have noticed that there's a few drops where it reads VIP bonus, guild skill, luck, which is obviously the one which you get from the luck stat. But behind some of the drops, there's in brackets a reason why you got it, right? And every core that does not tell you what you got it for is a basic drop, right? And based on how many you got, you get a percentage chance of rolling an additional one. For an example, if you do Caesar, right? You get five. Let's just pretend, I don't know if it's actually five. You get five basic drops. And I have 10 luck right now, which means I have a 15% chance per five of his basic drops to get one additional. So in theory, I could be doubling the basic drops with my luck. Obviously on 15%, that is very unlikely. However, with the current events running, with the scroll, with the sprint buff, with the guild buff, with the campfire, I can get up to 130 luck, which gives me a 45% chance per basic core to roll one additional one. And I actually had it happen where I think I got 6 luck cores in a single Caesar, and that is massive. That is really huge. The general way you get luck is a cadet badge, which is a premium item that you can also buy off of the marketplace, or you don't even need to spend money on it, because you should be buying the guild campfire every time that you do higher raids, and this guild campfire gives you 5 luck, so it already gives you the luck that you need to get one guaranteed, right? And on top of that, it also gives you a guild campfire buff. So if you don't have a cadet badge, at least get the campfire. This is actually massive for you as a free-to-play player or somebody who can not afford 7 mil every 30 days, which you should, by the way. Anyway, max HP. Pretty obvious, I think. Once this number reaches 0, you die. Similar with max stamina. When this number reaches 0, you're unable to do basically anything for a few seconds. Right, Herc? Those are the rules. Right? Can we respect? Okay, no? Okay, moving on. So, the next one is balance. And balance, again, is a not really straightforward, but it's easily explained. And once you know how it works, it's like, I get it. So, balance is basically the minimum percentage roll of your damage whenever you do attack, right? If you use the same skill like twice in a row, you'll notice that there's a very, very slim chance. It could happen, but the skill dealing the exact same amount of damage twice in a row, that's because balance is a thing. Whenever you deal damage, there's a calculation of how much of your actual damage you are dealing, and balance increases the minimum threshold of your damage. Balance is hard capped to 90, where I am in right now, so you can't always deal 100% of your damage. Don't ask me why, but they thought 90 is a pretty good number to cap, and is a really important one. I see a lot of new players disregarding this stat because they don't know what it's about, and they drop down to below 70, which you shouldn't be there, right? If you're below 70 compared to 90, you're missing at least. I mean, you could be lucky and always roll 100, right? If you are RNG blessed, but realistically, you are missing 20% guaranteed damage. I'm not trying to raise balance for being always be at 90, right? As a new player, being at 80 plus is perfectly fine. As a mid-range or mid-game player, 85 plus, but once you actually get into min-maxing, there should not be an excuse for you not being at 90 or 89 or very, very close to the 90, right? Again, as for new players, once you get your Astero weapon, really do make sure that you're using a Veiler suffix enchant scroll for balance, that you do max out all of the ores that yield balance, so you're not dropping too low on balance once you do your Dolahan to Astero weapon switch. Alright, let's go to attack speed. Attack speed, again, technically straightforward, right? The more you have, the faster you attack. There's one thing that I want to add in this explanation right here. It's about the R effects that I mentioned last time. If you remember, I said the Werewolf Paw gives you 20%. And I said something along the lines where if I use it on my 80 something attack speed Arisha, I go up to 120, so I get 40 points, which is not 20% of 86, obviously, right? And the maths behind it, it's also important for the dash enhanced scroll, which gives you 5% whenever you activate it. How it works is you have to add 200 points on top of what's listed right here. So when I do the 20% calculation for the Valve of Paw, it's not 20% of 86, it's 20% of 286. Because the engine has set the zero value to 200, right? So if it was actually zero, there wouldn't be any animation. But anyways, like, that's just for you to know. I'll actually skip attack limit removal for now, and I go to attack. This is, again, semi-straightforward, right? The more attack you have, 44.5k is what I do currently run, the more you have, the more damage you deal. However, there's something that we call attack limit. On Caesar, the newest boss, it is 39k. Me with my 44.5, I'm basically wasting 5.5. So I could have 5k less attack and I would still deal the same damage, right? That's what we call overcapping attack, or like future content, right? However, let's go back to the attack limit removal. And let's pretend it's 2k. I'm missing 10, but let's just pretend it's 2k. I have to add this number on top of the actual attack limit. So I am actually able to apply 41k attack, which obviously is a lot more and will increase my damage by a lot. Attack limit removal, however, is literally the last stat that you as a player have to focus on, or like will have to acquire. There's actually a lot of endgame players that are not going for it because it's actually very expensive, and people usually refer to it as the whale stat, where only people that actually are really wealthy can get it. However, it is really strong, right? Arguably. It is not strong enough for you to forfeit everything else and go straight for it. It's not that strong, but as a player that has literally everything else maxed, this is really good for you. Alright, on to the next one, defense. Again, kind of straightforward. The more you have, the less damage you take if you were to get hit by the enemy. However, this stat also has a cap to it, 29,000. If you are able to actually acquire more than 29,000, it does not benefit you, right? I'm still 5k away from it, so I don't need to be worried. But if I had golden bracelets or more pieces of Miletian armor, the Miletian focus, I would be pretty fucking close. The next two you can actually ignore, PvP attack and defense. They are literally the same as your regular attack and defense. They are listed separately because there used to be items that gave you only stats for PvP. Those were acquired within the PvP realm, so they wanted it to not have an impact on raiding back in season 1, but nowadays the PvE gear is like 100 times better, like literally, than like 10 times better, sorry, than the old PvE gear. So even PvP, you'd be wearing your PvE gear. So again, ignore these. On to the next one that is actually pretty interesting, and we are talking about critical. So when I started playing, I was like, what is this critical number? Is this a percentage? Do I have a 195% chance to crit an enemy? It doesn't feel like it because I'm not nearly critting enough for this, right? And it kind of is a percentage, but it's before you did the maths, right? So if I open up Caesar again and I hover view monster info, I can see he has a critical resistance of 145. And if I then subtract his 145 from my critical, I will end up on 50. And that is actually the percentage, how likely I am to critically hit him. It's also a good example because 50 is the highest percentage that you can apply to a raid. Again, we have a hard capped stat in critical right here. If I had 200 critical, I would not have a higher quit rate against Caesar. The highest that you can go as of me making this video is 200, or that you need to go, because the highest crit resistance boss is Bridget, the third Redeemer, and she has a 150 crit resistance. Alright, let's talk about crit damage, right? If you are critically hitting, you are dealing this much percent damage. 195, so almost double the damage. There are only two means of upgrading this. It's, as I mentioned earlier, 35% if you have your intelligence or strength at 2000. And then there's your crit hit mastery, which you should max, like, by the time you reach max level. Like, it's pretty up there on your priority list for pretty much every class. But yeah, I wish there was like another way of getting it, like an itemization, but hey. One stat that we actually don't need to bother about whatsoever, because everybody will have it maxed. If you don't have it at 195, you're probably doing something wrong. And you're in the endgame, right? If you're still leveling, right? You obviously won't be at 195. Alright, let's talk about crit resistance. It's literally the inverse, or reverse, sorry, of critical, where bosses do have a critical chance, and you have to subtract your crit resistance from their crit to figure out how likely they are to critically hit you. However, what I didn't mention on critical before is both receiving and outgoing critical hits do have a 3% minimum. So if the boss has more crit resistance than you have crit, you still have a 3% chance of critically hitting the enemy. But again, if you have more crit resistance than the enemy has crit, they also still have a 3% chance of critically hitting you. Alright, let's talk about what most people would call the most important stat in Vindictus, and it's additional damage. Ever since the RI's update, ever since they introduced this stat, it has been, I don't want to say controversial, but nowadays it's really only about how much of this can you stack, right? Because this is your RNG shit show. This is where enhancing your weapon and all of your armors comes into place, right? Because that's the only way you do get additional damage. If you inspect any player, this is probably like the first number you should be looking at. Like, are they at 6k? 6k is the magical number because it means your weapon and all of your armors are at plus 15. And that usually gives you a pretty good idea of how progressed their gear is. Because if a player is at 6k AD, that means he's most likely kept on balance, he is most likely kept on critical, his attack speed is probably rather high, stuff like that, because it takes a while to get there, right? I'm yet to see somebody one-shotting their weapon and all of their pieces of armor to plus 15, like, by just playing the game for the first time, right? This is your mid slash end game grind in the game. You will get all of the scrolls around the process of enhancing your stuff, and you will reforge your weapons, your armors, until you reach 6k. If you go beyond 6k, if you get a plus 16, which is not guaranteed because it's the first one that you actually have to YOLO, if you don't know how reforging and enhancing works, I have videos on my channel, so check these out. But 6k is guaranteed for everybody if you play long enough. Obviously, I'm fortunate enough to have a plus 16 weapon, so I got past it, which is really cool. There's also one neat information about additional damage, and it is 50% of your AD comes from your weapon if all of your items are on the same level. As an example, I explained to you how all plus 15 weapon and armors is 6k AD, right? That means 50% on your weapon, 3k is on a plus 15 weapon. That also means if you do successfully upgrade your weapon from 14 to 15, it is the same boost of AD as if you upgraded all of your armors from 14 to 15, right? Which, again, is probably, I don't want to call it easier, but you get the idea of it, right? weapon enhancements are just that much more valuable. But yeah, as a last note to AD, I really mean it as I say it. Please be blessed by Fergus himself. Get all of these 16s, 17s. Hell, even go all the way to 20. I would really love to see some ridiculous ones on EU NA. Because, yes, apparently plus 20 is a thing. No player in the world is yet to get there, right? I think the highest is plus 18. But there's still two levels to go, so hey, good luck. And let's talk about Counterforce, the actual last stat for today's video. And it's similar to Balance, where it's a percentage of your damage that is being touched. However, Counterforce is more so decreasing your damage if you don't have a certain amount of it, right? The way it works, let me pop up Caesar again. Hover his information, his counterforce resistance. It kind of works like critical and crit resistance, but his counterforce resistance is 55, and you do need 100 more counterforce than the counterforce resistance of a boss. So right now, since he is the latest raid that requires counterforce, the cap that you need to get to is 155. Getting more than 155 counterforce doesn't do anything for you right now, it's only future-proofing you. However, once you are 100 points above his counterforce resistance, you will deal 100% of your damage. Again, counterforce is not scaling linear, I think it's in steps of 5. Definitely let me know in the comments if it's 10, but I'm pretty sure it's every 5 counterforce that you get, you will deal more damage. And any counterforce that is only 30 above will not mean anything, because if you're on 0 counterforce and 30, you will only deal 30% of your damage. But again, if you have no counterforce, you probably won't be doing these counterforce raids. But yeah, there we have it, guys. I'm really sorry for the video probably being a bit longer today again, but I just figured it's finally time to make this video, so for anybody who was waiting for it, I'm really sorry. I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you liked it, I hope you learned something, and definitely let me know down, as always, below in the comments if you need something, if there's something I didn't explain well enough. Also, my Twitch and my Discord will be linked as always. So yeah, just have a great day and see you in my next one. Bye!